Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord, children. Hope you can hear me. Bwana asifiwe. I'm Teacher Mary. Niko hapa kuwaletea neno. And I want us to learn about obedience. About what, children? Obedience. And before I continue, I want us to sing a song, and I know you'll help me. You know the song. It is a short chorus. And I know you know it. It goes, Palikuwa na kijana mmoja, jina lake Samueli. Palikuwa na kijana mmoja, jina lake Samueli. Alisikia sauti ikimwita, Samueli, Samueli. Alisikia sauti ikimwita, Samueli, Samueli. Yes, I want us to talk about Samuel. I know this is a story that we all know about Samuel. And the theme of our lesson today is obedience. Obedience. I know you know what obedience is. And I know even at home right now, you are obeying your parents. And God bless you so much. So the book, we shall read from the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 1. It's Ephesians 6, verse 1. If you know it, you can recite as I read. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, that it may be well with you, and you may live long on earth. Bwana asifiwe sana. This is a memory verse that we know about obeying our parents. And because today I want us to learn about obedience, that's why I read that verse, Ephesians 6, verse 1. You can recite it for your parents even at home. Now, if I said we shall talk about Samuel. Samuel was a little boy, as we all know. He was living with Priest Eli in the temple. And one night, as we all know that he was dedicated by his parents to serve the Lord in the temple with Priest Eli, together with Priest Eli. So one night, as they were in the temple and as they were sleeping, Samuel was called. He was called Samuel, Samuel. So Samuel was an obedient boy. So he woke up very fast and ran to Eli. He told him, "You called me." Eli had not called him. So he told him, "Go back and sleep." And he was being called by God. So we see that Samuel was very obedient. When he was called, immediately he woke up, went to Eli, and asked him if he called him. And Eli told him no. That was the first time. But Eli, they didn't know who was calling Samuel. So Eli told Samuel, "Go back and sleep." That was the first time. The second time, Samuel was called. "Samuel, Samuel." He went, as usual, he ran to Eli and told him, "You called me." Eli told him to go back and sleep. That was the second time. He was called again the third time. "Samuel, Samuel." He again ran to Eli and told him, "You called me." Eli again told him, "No, go back and sleep." By this time, Eli realized that it was God who was calling him. So he told him, "When you are called again, say, speak, your servant is listening. Speak, your servant is listening." So Samuel went back to sleep. Remember, at this time he was called three times. Then he went back to sleep, to his sleep. And then he heard again the voice calling him, "Samuel, Samuel." That was the fourth time. And he said, "Speak, your servant is listening." So all this long, it was God who was calling Samuel. And you have seen that whenever Samuel was called, he ran to Eli. The three times he was called, he went to Eli and told him, he called, he asked him what he was saying. So we realized that Samuel was an obedient boy, even though he didn't know who was calling him, because he was only with Eli in the temple. He thought it was Eli. But the fourth time, Eli told him, when you are called again, say, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. So he was called the fourth time, Samuel, Samuel. And then he responded, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Praise God. Bwana asifiwe. So Samuel was an obedient boy. We are learning about obedience. We are learning about what, children? Obedience. So we are learning that Samuel was very obedient. And so even us as children, I know right now you are at home, we are supposed to obey our parents. Bwana asifiwe, be obedient like Samuel was. We are supposed to obey our parents at home. We are supposed to obey our elders. We are also supposed to obey our teachers. Continue obeying your teachers. We are also supposed to obey the authority. Right now, I know what is happening. We have a very dangerous disease, and we are praying God that soon it will end so that we go back to school. I'm talking about obeying the authorities. Right now, we are being told, we are being given the guidelines to follow so that we keep away this disease. We are told we wash our hands, we keep social distance, we wear our mask. We should obey that. That is obeying the authority. I know you know the CEO, sorry, for health, who is really giving these guidelines. So obey him, obey the authority. We obey our parents, elders, teachers, and authority. Bwana asifiwe sana. So, as Samuel did, Samuel obeyed the voice of the Lord. And later God gave him the message that he wanted to give him. And we know that Samuel later became, that time he was a little boy, and later he became a prophet. So out of obedience, Samuel became a prophet. So even us, when we obey the people I've told you to obey, I know God will make us what he wants us to be. We shall be what God wants us to be. So obey your parents, be obedient children, and out of that, God will bless you. Bwana asifiwe sana. So we were talking about obedience. We have seen that Samuel was obedient. He was called by God four times and he responded. So we have to be obedient. If we were, and out of this obedience, God will make us what he wants us to be. So God bless you so much. Even as you obey at home, you obey your parents, God bless you so much. My name is Teacher Mary. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we come before thy presence this moment. I want to thank you, Jehovah Lord, for thy teaching that you've given unto us. I pray that this word shall help our children, even if they are at home, dear Lord. I pray, King of Glory, that you may put the fruit of obedience in their hearts, Lord, that at this time they obey their parents, dear Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for everything. I bless them. I glorify your name because you are going to do them good. Bless their parents also as they toil and moil, Jehovah Father, for their upkeep even now when they are at home, dear Lord. I worship you and glorify your name. For this I pray in Jesus' name. And all say, amen. Kwaherini, till we meet again.